loaded. They unleashed with incredible volley that basically shredded that car and the people in it.
The shootout lasted only seconds, but in the end, the car was riddled with more than 150 bullets.
Ted Hint says when they pulled them out of the car, they were nothing but wet rags. So you can understand what a steel jacket bullet can do to a human body. Clyde's head was pretty well blown off, and she's blown all pieces.
My father had a 16-millimeter home movie camera. The staff photographer for the Dallas Times Herald gave it to him. He told him, he said, you're going to get them eventually, and when you do, you're going to need to document it. He carried that camera for 17 months.
The posse sorted through Bonnie and Clyde's possessions. Bonnie's makeup case, several suitcases, road maps and true crime magazines. Hamer claimed their guns and fishing tackle as a reward. Word spread quickly, and people began to crowd Highway 154. Souvenir hunters scavenged through the carnage.
People started coming in, clipping off pieces of clothing. One man took a pocket knife and was trying to cut off Clyde's trigger finger as a trophy. One person was stopped by one of the officers from trying to take Bonnie's wedding ring off her hand.
Later that evening, Bonnie and Clyde's parents retrieved the bodies, having learned of their deaths when reporters called for comment.
My grandfather said, you know, it was terrible what he saw. They'd broken down to tears, you know, having to go pick his son up and saying what the condition they were.
In life, it's very